At the risk of sounding like a Bottas fanboy, I wanted to make just one more video of him before we put the whole Mercedes and Alfa Romeo story to rest. So today, I want to talk again about Valtteri Bottas, and especially how a Grand Prix weekend right after his Mercedes exit announcement completely changed the Formula One fans' perception of this guy. The 6 years he served as the wingman of Lewis in his current role, he has struggled to leave a real mark in the sport. Perhaps the way in which he was racing this weekend showed how much weight he was carrying weekend after weekend and how well he can perform without that burden on his shoulders. Bottas has always been the unlucky one, having more frequent technical problems compared to his teammate and making the human errors at the worst possible times. Valtteri Bottas never managed to show what he can during his time in Mercedes. But that is until now. His performance at Monza last weekend was evidence of what he can do on a Grand Prix weekend. Winning the qualifying session on Friday and claiming the first in the sprint, he was guaranteed a Grand Prix win if not for the engine penalty that he had to serve. But more than anything, this also showed what level of a pressure he was under the last many years, and now finally out of it, what he is actually able to achieve in the sport. In many ways, I feel Bottas has become the new Raikkonen. Apart from the caliber these both world-class drivers have, there are several similarities that we can notice between the two. Both from Finland, both men of few words, both moving from a championship-worthy teams, and both given the responsibility to lead a lower midfield team. It was interesting to see how Bottas in the last few weeks have kind of taken over the Raikkonen style of talking to the media. If this continues, I believe we will miss Raikkonen a bit less once he retires. It would be interesting to see who is going to be the future teammate of Bottas. But if Giovinazzi is re-signed, it would be interesting to see how the battle for the top spot in the team will evolve. Any rookie would have less chances to be better than Bottas next year, but Giovinazzi, with a couple of years experience at Alfa Romeo, would definitely give Bottas a run for his money. Until now, with no decision or announcement on the second driver of Mercedes, Bottas was in a dilemma of whether he should follow or go against the team orders if it is unfavorable to his race. But we could see him not treating the team orders with that much regard from now on. It is highly likely that Hamilton will still finish ahead of Bottas for most of the races, but it is unlikely Bottas will give way to Hamilton in races where he has a clear chance to win. Bottas has been compared with Russell quite often in the past. Time will tell how well Russell will do in Mercedes, but chances are he would create more problems for Mercedes than solving them. I think in future, fans and experts could be comparing Bottas back to Russell and wondering why he was ever replaced. Bottas had always fit in well in the second driver role, which Russell would never agree to. That means if Mercedes has a championship-worthy car next year, we could see a toxic team battle and several incidents involving both the drivers. I would end this video with two crazy thoughts for Bottas's future. Number one, could Bottas outperform Hamilton in the rest of the season? Chances of that are very low. But what is certain is, Bottas' second half of the season will be better than the first half. If he keeps up, third place is highly likely for him. Number 2. Can Alfa Romeo take advantage of the new regulations and become world champions? Again, chances are very less, but they could definitely go up to upper midfield and return results like Alfa Tauri is doing currently. 2022 is going to be an exciting year for many reasons, and we now got more reasons to be excited for the next season. I believe we are yet to see the best of Bottas, and we will most likely see it starting next year as the new Raikkonen of Formula One. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit that like button. Consider subscribing to the channel if you like to watch similar content. And stay tuned to I Am Formula for everything Formula One. Until next time, take care and stay safe.